Hello, my dear students. Myself Shegunaz. Now I am here with the topic of ancient civilization, part 3 for the student of 6th standard. Dear students, in the last video you have saw about the Egyptian civilization and Mesopotamian civilization. Now let us discuss about another important civilization, that is Chinese civilization. Here you can see Chinese civilization students. The country that lies to the east of India in China. The Yellow Caucasian Mongolian tribes are the ancestors of this place. Here students, the people, those who lived here were Mongolian tribes, and here Yangtze, Sichuan and Huanghu Yellow rivers are the prominent rivers of this region. So they are called the cradles of Chinese civilization. And what happened here students, initially they ruled from the villages. Gradually they developed foreign trade by growing paddy and silk. Now let us see the political history. You can see students here, the writing is there, that is pictographic script. Here is the image of pictographic script. Now let us see, the first ruling family was the Shang dynasty. During the period of Chinese civilization, the first family was ruling. This is Shang dynasty. It ruled in the period between the 18th century BCE and the 12th century BCE. The Chinese had mastered the craft of producing bronze and porcelain dishes. Huanghu was the famous king of Zhou dynasty. The well-known philosophers Confucius and Laozi lived in this period. Qin dynasty came to power after Zhou dynasty. The name China is derived from the Qin dynasty. And you know what students, here the Shang dynasty was replaced by the Zhou dynasty, which ruled for a longer time. Now let us see the another famous king of Qin dynasty, that is Shi Huangdi. He was a famous king of Qin dynasty. He unified China and brought it under a uniform law. He is called as the first emperor of China. He built a 1500 mile long Great Wall of China to protect China from the onslaught of enemies. You can see the students, the Great Wall of China, it comes under the seven wonders of the world presently. Now China was ruled by Han dynasty after Qin dynasty. This period considered as the golden age in China. Here you can see the image of the Great Wall of China. Why he built this much big wall is here. The reason behind this is students, to protect them from the enemies. Now let us see the another famous king, that is Wu Ti. He was a famous king of Han dynasty who established a vast empire. There was a great demand for silk in Rome. And here students, there was a great demand for silk in Rome. As a result, the trade route between China and Rome became famous as the Silk Route. Buddhism entered China during this period. And here art and architecture received a great patronage, the rule of Han dynasty. Hence, this period is known as the golden age of in the history of China. During the rule of Song dynasty, which came to power after Han dynasty, that is wood printing press and production of porcelain dishes started. The Mongolians ended the rule of Song dynasty by conquering Peking, the capital of Song dynasty, today's Beijing, the capital of China. Here, before Song dynasty is now presently known as Beijing dynasty. Now let us see the contribution of Chinese civilization. The contribution of the Chinese civilization to the ancient world was a remarkable. Here student, they introduced tea and silk to the world. In addition to this, the invention like paper made of bamboo, explosives, painting brush, porcelain and mariner's compass goes to the credit to China. As you can see nowadays also students, we can see many materials resources which we are using is made from China only. They use pictographic script to write. As I showed you the image of pictographic script, This was used in China. They used to write on a bamboo slips vertically from the top to the bottom. And here, Laozi and Confucius enriched the field of philosophy. Laozi taught simple living, sacrifice, and harmonious relationship with nature. And Confucius re-established the lost moral and social values in the society. Here you can see the students, this was the contribution of Chinese civilization. We'll be continued the other civilization in our next video. Thank you for watching my video, students. And another important thing is, note it down the every important point in your notebook. So thank you.